Very good evening, students. Today we are going to derive the relation for Clausius-Clapeyron equation. So this equation firstly founded by Clapeyron in the year of 1834 using the concept of Carnot cycle, and later on by Clausius using the concept of thermodynamic Maxwell's equation in the year of 1850. They both gives the relation between the latent heat, change in pressure, change in volume, and the change in melting or boiling point, you can say that change in temperature during the change in the phase of substance, which is called first latent heat equation, which is very useful to determine the effect of pressure on the melting as well as boiling points of the substance. So that's why I'm writing dp is change in pressure, dv is change in volume, this is change in temperature, or you can say that change in melting or boiling point when we change phase. So for driving a relation Clausius and Clapeyron equation, we consider a component having two systems, or you can say that having two phases. For example, we consider a example of water in which we consider two phases, like solid or liquid, or you can say that liquid or gas according to you. So here is a graph of this figure. We have pressure and volume. So in this it shows two isothermals A, B, C, D and E, F, G, H for a certain substance at temperature T and T minus DT respectively. So DC and HD denote the solid or liquid phase, whereas BA and FE denote the corresponding liquid or vapor phases respectively. So the parts CB and GF shows the change in phase in progress. Both phases exist in equilibrium. Evidently, the two changes in phase occur at slightly different temperature and pressures. This Clausius and Clapeyron equation gives the relation between the change in temperature with pressure. So for that, to derive the equation, draw the two adiabatics, that is B I and C J. Let the volume of the substance corresponding to the points B C be V1 and V2 respectively. Let us assume that the isothermals are drawn for unit mass of substance. So for that, B, C, J, I becomes an elementary Carnot cycle to which the unit mass of substance has been subjected. Let Q be the latent heat, or you can say that heat absorbed. Delta Q is work done. So according to the efficiency of Carnot cycle. Now what is the efficiency? Efficiency is output divided by input, and we know that output is change in work done and input is heat which is absorbed by that Carnot cycle, is equal to change in temperature divided by total temperature of that system. Write it as equation number 1. So here Q is the latent heat of the substance for the change of phase under consideration. Let Q is equal to L, that's why I'm replacing Q, that is heat absorbed is equal to latent heat, which is denoted by capital L. Write it as equation number 2. So also work done during the Carnot cycle is equal to the area of B, C, J, I, which can be treated as elementary rectangle with sides. BC is equal to V2 minus V1. You can say that change in phase volume phase 2 in phase 1, that is V2 minus V1, and other side is BI is equal to change in pressure, that is DP. So therefore change in work done is equal to, when we substitute these two values over here, so it will be delta Q is equal to, you can say that delta W is equal to DP into V2 minus V1. Write it as equation number 3. Or from these three equations you can write change in pressure into change in volume from second phase to first phase divided by latent heat is equal to change in temperature divided by temperature. So by this I am calculating change in pressure by change in temperature is equal to latent heat divided by temperature into change in volume into two phases. So this is the required Clausius-Clapeyron equation. In this case, if V2 is greater than V1, that means V2 minus V1 is positive. If V2 is less than V1, that means volume is decreases in that case, or you can say that there is a decrease in volume on the change in phase from solid to liquid or liquid to vapor. The melting or boiling point decrease with increase in pressure. So decrease in volume occur only certain case of the change in phase space from solid to liquid. However, in the case of vaporization, volume invariably increases in all the cases. So that's why we consider this special case in which we can say that both the phases have equal volume, or you can say that on phase first volume is V1, on second phase volume is V2. So for that states, we can say that V1 is equal to V2, or if V1 is equal to V2, that means V2 minus V1 is equal to 0. So for that, writing this factor is equal to this, we find for V2 minus V1 is equal to 0, either latent heat is 0, or you can say that for vaporization near the critical point, latent heat is 0. That is, the substance vaporizes with little or no absorption of heat. So that's why I'm writing dP by dt approximately is equal to infinity for that case. So physicists call this equation is first latent heat equation and other is thermodynamic Clausius equation in the honor of two scientists. So physicist will tell us how much vapor pressure is changed with the help of temperature. We can calculate with this Clausius-Clapeyron equation. So have a look. So now we're going to derive again Clausius-Clapeyron equation from Maxwell's equation. So change in liquid into vapor or solid into liquid vice versa is known as phase transition. So according to phase transition, we are going to derive Clausius-Clapeyron equation in case of thermodynamics. So which is help in determine the effect of pressure on the melting as well as boiling point of the substance. So according to phase transition, we consider a component having two phases, or you can say that having two states, like liquid change into vapor or solid change into liquid vice versa. This process is known as phase transition. So according to Maxwell's thermodynamic second relation, we can say that change in entropy divided by change in volume having constant temperature is equal to change in pressure by change in temperature when volume is constant. Now we consider this Maxwell's second equation. So we're going to multiply both sides by temperature. Why are we going to multiply these two equations with the temperature? Because we know providing heat. That's why we multiply with temperature. So it will be T, this rest factor as it is, also T into this term. Now we know that T into dS, temperature into entropy, is equal to heat, that is delta Q. So instead of this, I'm writing delta Q. So relation will be delta Q divided by delta V, or you can say that curly V having temperature constant is equal to this rest function is as it is. If delta Q be the latent heat, or you can say that heat absorbed during the phase transition when change in volume is delta V, so we can write delta Q divided by delta V is equal to this factor. So write it as equation number 1. The left hand side of above equation represent the change in heat of with respect to change in volume at constant temperature. This is what happens during phase transition. So that's why I'm writing delta Q divided by delta V. So if we consider unit mass of substance, then delta Q is replaced with the help of latent heat, that is L. Also, Vf is final volume. You can say that volume of second phase. Vi, you can say that initial volume, or in other words, we can say that volume of first phase. Delta V is change in volume into second phase to first phase. So equation 1 may be written as change in pressure by temperature when volume is constant is equal to latent heat divided by temperature into change in volume, that is Vf minus Vi. This is equation number 2, or you can say that this is Clapeyron equation. Now delta T by delta P, or you can say that delta P by delta T when constant is volume, represents change in melting point or boiling point with pressure at constant volume. So if we call the significance of this Clapeyron equation, so it is applicable for any substance, or you can say that any phase change, any melting or boiling point changes, we applied this equation over there. And in other words, we can say that if volume is decreases on phase change, then Vif minus Vi is equal to negative. If this factor is equal to negative, that means ratio of this also will be negative. What it means, increase in pressure, decrease the volume at which the process occurs. For example, when ice melts, volume decreases. Therefore, when pressure increases, melting point decreases. That's it. Hope so. It is clear to all. Thank you.